Hello and welcome to Fellsburg, where we have just arrived at our brand new farm, which we have purchased under a land contract. It comes with almost everything we need, and it should be great to start out on. So, it comes with everything you see here: two tractors, a combine, trailer, grain storage, a shop, and all of our equipment. We already have our truck, which can be used as a farm implement if we need to. We've got a quite small equipment, but we do have a house. So basically, the deal with this is we owe 50% of every harvest profits to the farmer which we bought it from. He was getting ready to retire, so he decided to get out of the business. Now, well, since we're gonna just sit here, I will show you what we got going on. We own fields 19, 20, 28, and 29. We are gonna fill these in. Let's see. Probably gonna grow either soybeans or canola in 19. And then 20, 28, and 29, we'll have three smaller crops. Now let's see. Might as well get to work. This is the 7250, the biggest model of the... So we start out with $15,000, and that's our running cost. Anything extra we make is ours, but from the harvest, we owe 50% of the harvest to the old farmer who used to operate this until we pay off $500,000 is what he's charging us. As we get filled up, we will head out to field number 19. Let's see. What do we want? Let's find out. We're gonna put this on a worker. Well, we probably go into a contract. I can't sit here and seed forever. I don't know about you guys, but I can't sit there and seed forever. Let's see. Yep, he's getting along just fine. Let's see here. Alright. I'm just wasting my fertilizer, if that's alright. It'll be okay. So let's see. We got the TX32, quite an old combine, but it'll do for what we got to do with. We have this Armatrek 1104. Does come with a loader. Let's see, what do we got for contracts? Let's see if we can make some extra money here. We could do a cotton harvest on field 14. Is that a big field? Yeah. I don't really want to do... Yeah, let's do that, actually. Nah. Let's do this one. Let's just accept this contract. There's field 5. Oh no. That's a long ways away. It's a long drive. No. 6 slides we get all the way up to 5. Which just means we'll get the just gonna set the trailer. It's a really slow process. So but that she gets out, just yeah, this one takes. Now that we made that nice big drive, we can almost get 55. Then we can set this guy up on the worker. We'll go back and get our trailer. Taking on a little off-road excursion here. Take this time to mention in this series, everything is ours. We're just under land contract and giving half of our harvest for every all the 4 fields that we get. So if we make enough money to buy another field, that's fine, but we have to keep paying off our land contract and we do not have to pay 50% on those fields. Just our 4 initial fields. And we are responsible for the maintenance and upkeep. That's why we're going to do some contracts so we can make sure we afford this farm that we're in. Now, this harvest is pretty cheap for a contract, so I'm really surprised I took it. I wasn't looking at the price very well, so, you know, hopefully make good on the extra grain. See you again in a sec. Alright, so we're arriving back at the field. Let's see how full our combine is. Let's see if we need to unload him when he comes back through again. Yeah, probably have to make sure I'll get him back and take him back out again. Let's see how our seeder's getting on. He's got, what, half the field done, maybe? Let's see here. About a third, maybe. And the seeder works really fast, but it's also very narrow, so as we get through here, we're going to probably upgrade this fairly soon. It'll be worth it at the harvest place. As soon as he turns around, we're going to unload him here, because that's what needs to get done. I should probably be doing this myself instead of wasting money on a worker, since we're on a pretty tight budget at the moment. Once I get lower my work. Let's see where we're at. 80%, sweeping, steal all the cream, it'll be fine. Gonna pull a little sneaky one in there, huh? Alright. We're going in between the trees. Man, there's crop destruction on, and that must not count if it's a worker or something, because that would totally be monstrous. Let's
back over to you. The combine.
And we'll this combine, even for being so old, it's nice and detailed. It's even got cup holders. Area meter. Does that actually work, I wonder? No. That'd be so weird if that actually worked. River. So this farm I plan to expand as soon as possible and gain this farm some size. We'll work on equipment. We might struggle for a while with the size of equipment. It's going to take us longer. But we'll go to farm first before we go to equipment. And that's the way I find to make money in this game. Now, we're going to do quite a few contracts in the first couple of years to make it worth it. And a little bit bigger contracts than the ones we took together. It seems to me that fertilizing contracts or like root crop harvesting is the best way to make money from contracts. But the root crop harvesting, you just, I found you almost just gotta let it go on the worker and just go for it. And that's the only way to make money. Continue on with your farm where that guy just trucked and go and load him at home tomorrow. Cotton out of really good fields, pretty good too. Because you can just let that harvester run and then come pick up the bales after he's done. I think I'm going to take a quick head and off this point. Just to give myself a little bit more room. I'm gonna go down the back end here. Get a little parking space, get a little more turn around. I think I'm gonna make a left turn here and come back to the field. Just get as much of this field out of here as I can. getting down to the moon. I'm gonna bring the tractor over. Now this is a haul from Field 5 to the main farm. It's a long ways. Having to drive this thing just down the mountain, hope I don't hit any trees, but probably won't end up doing that. And we're almost empty here. Thinking we might expand to maybe buy one more field, and then if we get enough grain and storage, we might work on some livestock. I know horses, we can get the horse Pokemon card. Just a crazy profitable. I don't know about start from scratch mode or normal difficulty, what they end up getting up to in the economy, but it's gotta be pretty good. I know on easy they get up to about 50,000, I believe. Which, 100% profit, can't pass that up. Whoops, I accidentally hit player worker. Did not mean to do that. Now, because the field is perfect, I mean, I'm gonna hit this. This is only a 3-meter wide cedar, so pretty small, but it looks like I'm going to be able to seed all my field without any problems. And it looks like let's see here. 3 out of my 4 fields are fully fertilized, so as soon as I put in some crop, they will be fully fertilized and I won't have to touch them except for weeding them. And I have that Armatrack, I think it's Armatrack, right? Yeah, Armatrack. Perfectly set up to weed, fertilize, whatever we need. It's looking like I'm gonna be able to fit it all in this trailer. I don't know where this contract needs to be offloaded to. Train station mill, which is all the way back down the farm. Alright. Let's see what the price is. No. $12.28. Alright. Not bad. Take a look at him for a little bit. Now what I may do, if I keep getting direct seeders, is I might sell my cultivator and use that money to upgrade this seeder. I don't know, it might be worth it. I'm not sure yet, we'll find out. this one are basically everything kitted out to go. And then he got sick, so he decided he was done farming, so he sold off most of his land and his larger equipment, so we were left with anything that was left in his yard. So now basically we're paying for his retirement. Those beacons. This farm also has the double yield mod, which I enjoy because some of this is pretty difficult to gain money and build your farm up. So when you can use a double yield mod, helps you make a little more on contracts, helps you make a little more on small fields. Once we get to some larger fields, I'll probably turn it off. Once we establish some stuff, but helps to make everything a little more interesting, helps advance faster. Just gives you a better experience. Pretty close to a place right here. This is 21,000 acres, I believe, so it should be a pretty good harvest. He's gonna be almost done, huh? Another half a green can, maybe. Green maybe 2,000 meters, 3,000 meters.
No.
Definitely not the 5 that we have in the tank. So we're going to be just shy of the full trailer, which isn't bad. And we're going to go complete this contract. And then I think we're going to call it in, so we're going to take the drain in and make a little bit of money here. Maybe make back what it costs to fill our cedar. Maybe make a little money for fuel here. Because I know it cost us some money to get this back way up here. Apparently this can fit this entire room inside her. A little unrealistic, but hey, it's going to let me do what I'm going to do. Man, only 1,000 meters basically, not even. Better from in cab, actually. You can judge it a little bit better because I just go full blast most of the time, which is not the greatest, but it works. And this armor track, it's a pretty nice tractor. It's a little guy, but it'll be a good loader tractor and stuff. I probably won't actually say it. It'll probably stay in the loader tractor. I'm not fertilizing tractor unless I feel I need some more power. Get loaded and throw some big weights in the back and call it good. So we got to turn left and then left and then out here. And get up to the transfusion and make our money. We only make like $1,500 contract, but it'll be alright. We'll be good. $1,200 plus $15, so we made $26. 700. About. Here's how to complete this contract. So we did a little bit. We might do some big fertilizing job or something like that. We might get the money next time. We'll get back to the farm. And I'll sort out that combine next time. Once we get back to the farm, I think we're gonna call it good for the day. See you when we get back to the farm. Alright, we're just about pulling in the farm here, so that's good. We'll put a trailer away for now. We're back to the shed here. Get her back in here. Now the one thing I would like to invest in is some grass equipment, so maybe we'll think about that once we get some of these fields going. And I'm gonna let him keep on carrying on here. Get this field all seamed up for me. So, hit. Yes. I'm going to do a home farm if you ever do. I'm going to grab across the freshly seeded ground. I'm going to make a couple crossroads here. That means just to simplify this guy's job. I think with one tank of this cedar, I'm going to be able to get all of my field sown, so there's that. So, alright guys, thanks for watching. Bye.